Ktisis Hyperboreia. May put you not, but I trust you understanding where we are. There may be some spoilers in this, so if you have not played this part in the story and you're interested in keeping it preserved until you get to it, I highly suggest you watch this later. But if you just want to see the dungeon using the trust system, here we go. And I have not been in this either, so this is going to be a new experience for all of us. First to what? Guy to... This is a Hyperboreia. Have you ever wondered whether your creation is a beneficial existence to start? Wonder no more. Here at Ktisis Hyperboreia, our mission is to determine an answer from temperate plains, tropical dungeons, jungles, from wandering volcanoes, across the fields and creations, to the proof of a wide range of meticulously recreated environments. Will your creation be able to survive in the wider world, or will it threaten the survival of other species? The answers to such questions and more are highly trained staff going forward. Interesting. Alright, so we're gonna jump in. Couple mobs to start out with. Fancy looking lines, and dickhead. Well, brontosaurus rex, or whatever you want to call it. You can go this way. We have a big pile of cactus here. No. I've got a little ways to go yet before we get to where I'm going. Ooh, it's all four. I didn't know if that was too true or if that was gonna be straight up four four. Pretty relaxing. Thank you. plus. Experimental artifacts arrive at the frozen sphere. That's pretty cool, but I don't know. This one's just gonna kind of create threat on the other one and beat down the one that they're targeting here. We're gonna force our way, he said. Let's see if this boss does. He's all the game of the tank buster. It's a crossfire seek. You gotta watch the smoke screens. Thank you. good. Alright, let's see what kind of goodies we got. We get anything? Frankie. Oop. They don't pull by the class as it usually is, but I don't run house on. Alright, what about our number? More dickheads?
I see you.
was the observation. According to Mr. Solista, her creation is based on a concept for black wolf, and indeed it's oppressively man-like in its gait. It's also highly intelligent, as it's evidenced by its ability to employ tools, while the gleam in its eyes gives the impression that it comprehends our words. If this proves to be the case, it would be ashamed that its throat isn't designed for speech. I must make mention of this in the next report. What is it different? Trimble to number 4 on this one. Thank you. Yeah. Oh. haunted by that treasure chest. They weren't done with it. That flying lifeline is an introduction. Successful creation of migratory birds which travel between patterns with seasons came as a breath of fresh air to a long stagnant realm of flying lifelines. In the end, it was a relatively simple thing to grant creatures the ability to navigate by celestial bodies, but this method lacked the precision needed to guide them to the same location each time as would be vital to their survival. The breakthrough came in the form of magnetic fields, the use of which was discovered by the incumbent Vandania during his tenure as chief overseer of Opus, a truly inspired idea that has brought lasting benefits to the star. Great. Oh. We need to attack again? Oh. Well, we're not going to get some of those moves either.
Alright.
Moving on. Armored and Jesse Hooker? Hey, look at that. Hooker. Oh shit. This doesn't look like it's gonna end well for somebody.
So, it comes to this. I have no wish to fight, but this time, I cannot yield. Though the world may think me a mad, desperate fool, I will hold fast to my conviction.
This. Yeah. That's what he wants to do, so I guess we gotta do it, right? Here we go. You're getting very low, are you? No, you're not. I guess we have to use the block to stop us getting pushed. One way to do this is to do it. One way to learn it. I'm gonna come a little bit closer though, jeez. I'll go back through all the ships. just needed to eat an Archon roll first. Alright, so let's try this again. First things first, I think I need him dead center.
I will have the time and tranquility I require. Trust and hail, gather to me!
Okay, let's just give him some splash damage. So this looks like a safe spot right there, I know. I'm using this correctly.
Exhaustion wins! Here's my blow! Stars on high! War is ready!
And meteors are gonna drop. This is not interesting in giving up yet. And there we have it, that's the dungeon. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you on the next one.